Now see, today we will start a new chapter, chapter number 8, that is quadrilateral, standard 9th CBSE, subject maths. Now see, first of all, we learn what do you mean by quadrilateral. What is the definition of quadrilateral? How I define? A quadrilateral is 4 points. Are given. And no three out of four, no 3 points are collinear. No 3 points out of four points are collinear. Then by joining the 4 points, 4 points in order, a closed figure is formed. Closed figure is formed. That closed figure is called a quadrilateral. This closed figure, we call it as a quadrilateral. Or you can say it is a polygon, right, formed by four sides. Any closed figure containing three or more than three sides, we call it as a polygon. So quadrilateral is a polygon having four sides. That way also you can define. See figure. Look at this figure. Suppose you are given 4 points A, B, C, and suppose D is here. So this A, B, C, D in order, we call it as a quadrilateral. What is called? This is a quadrilateral. In this quadrilateral, you see, you are given this, if you are, you joined A and C. This is one of the diagonal, and if you join B and D, if I join AC and then BD. So AC and BD are the diagonal of a quadrilateral. So I can say a quadrilateral ABCD has four sides, like AB, BC, CD, and DA. Quadrilateral has four sides. Not only that, four angles. It has four angles. Triangle mein sikhata na, three angles. Like angle A, angle B, angle C, and angle D. Triangle mein sikhata na, three sides, three angles, and three vertices. Same way, quadrilateral has got four sides, four angles, and it has four vertices. Like A, B, C and D, and two diagonals, It has two diagonals. And what are those two diagonals? AC and BD. Clear? So this is a total introduction of quadrilateral. See figure. In figure you can see all this thing. Now there are different types of quadrilateral. There are different types of quadrilateral because all the following figure are having four sides only. And they are all these following figures are quadrilateral also. There are different types of quadrilateral. Number one, like parallelogram, then second, rectangle, then third, rhombus, all these things you have learned in your standard 8. Fourth, square, right? Fifth, trapezium, and sixth, kite. 14 January mein kya karte ho aap? It's a kite flying day, okay? These are all different types of quadrilateral. Now, what is the angle sum property of quadrilateral? Angle sum property of triangle we have learned ki sum of all three angles of triangle is 180. So now we are going to learn angle sum properties of a quadrilateral. See, the property says that the sum of angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. How do I get this? We can verify this statement or we can verify this fact by dividing it into two triangles by joining AC, okay? One diagonal. Suppose this is your quadrilateral, okay? A, B, C, D is a quadrilateral. You joined AC, okay? Then this angle is 1, this angle I call it as 2, this angle I call it as a 4 and this angle I call it as a 3. Clear? And this angle I call it as D and this angle I call it as B. Because D and B are not divided by any of the diagonal. Now see, according to angle sum property, what is angle sum property? A plus B plus angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D. इज इक्वल टू मुझे 360 लाना है. एंगल ए के लिए मैं लिखूंगी एंगल 1 प्लस एंगल 2, राइट? एंगल बी के लिए मैं लिखूंगी एंगल बी. एंगल सी के लिए मैं लिखूंगी एंगल 3 प्लस एंगल 4 और एंगल डी के लिए मैं लिखूंगी एंगल डी. नाउ आई विल कलेक्ट एंगल 1, एंगल 3 एंड एंगल डी. एंगल 1, देखो एंगल 1, एंगल 3 एंड एंगल डी, ओके? एंगल 1, एंगल 3 प्लस एंगल डी इन वन ब्रैकेट एंड अनदर ब्रैकेट में एंगल 2 प्लस एंगल 4 प्लस एंगल बी. क्लियर? सो दिस इज एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ ट्राइंगल एबीडी. sorry, ACD. So this is 180 degree and this is another triangle, and some angle, some property of triangle is 180 degree. So 180 degree plus 180 degree is 360 degree. So I can verify this statement by this figure. Now see first type of quadrilateral, and that is a parallelogram. We learn about parallelogram. Parallelogram is always a quadrilateral, but all quadrilateral are not a parallelogram. Parallelogram is a special case of quadrilateral. Okay? Under what condition a quadrilateral is going to become a parallelogram? If both pairs of opposite side, if both pairs of opposite sides of a quadrilateral, opposite sides of a quadrilateral, are parallel, then it is called a parallelogram. Then it is called a parallelogram. पूरा स्पेलिंग नहीं लिखना है तो शॉर्ट वे ऑफ राइटिंग पैरेललोग्राम दो पैरेलल लाइन करके जीएम लिख दो. This is a symbolic way of writing parallelogram. Let us see the figure. This is a figure of parallelogram. Rough banati hu. Look here. It is A, B, C, D. Here A, B, C, D is a parallelogram. Parallelogram. Why? Because AB is parallel to DC and BC is parallel to AD. So both pair of opposite sides are parallel to each other. Therefore it is a parallelogram. Okay? Now what are the properties of parallelogram? So all parallelogram are quadrilateral, but quadrilateral, all quadrilateral are not parallelogram. Okay? Properties. There are different properties of parallelogram. First property is the diagonals of a parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. Okay? A diagonal. Suppose I join diagonal AC, then diagonal divide parallelogram into two congruent triangles Quadrilateral may it is not true, okay? Quadrilateral may divide into two triangle, but not, it should not be a congruent. Okay? Quadrilateral may be diagonal divide the quadrilateral into two triangles, but they are not congruent. But in case of parallelogram, the two triangles are going to become a congruent. Okay? Second properties of, a property aap verify bhi kar sakte hain, AC joint kar do. और फिर दो ट्रायंगल कॉन्ग्रुएंट कर दो. इन ट्रायंगल ए बी सी एंड सी डी ए, ए बी इज इक्वल टू सी डी, बी सी इज इक्वल टू ए डी एंड ए सी एसी कॉमन. सो बाय एस 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 रूल यू कैन से टू ट्रायंगल आर कॉन्ग्रुएंट. यू कैन प्रूव ईच एंड एवरी प्रॉपर्टी, ओके, बाय द कॉन्ग्रुएंसी ऑफ ट्रायंगल. ओके, सी आई कैन प्रूव दिस प्रॉपर्टी जस्ट बाय, I can show you how this can be proved. Suppose this is my parallelogram A B C D. Don't look at the figure. मान लो ये rough figure है. AC joint कर दिया मैंने. अब in triangle A B C, एंड ट्राइंगल CDA. क्या करोगे आप? AB इज इक्वल टू CD, राइट. फिर BC इज इक्वल टू क्या आएगा? DA. एंड AC इज इक्वल टू AC कॉमन. क्लियर? बराबर. देयरफॉर ट्राइंगल ABC इज कॉन्ग्रुएंट टू ट्राइंगल CDA बाय SSS रूल. क्लियर? सो आई कैन प्रूव ईच एंड एवरी प्रॉपर्टी बाय कॉन्ग्रुएंसी ऑफ ट्राइंगल. क्लियर? नाउ सेकंड प्रॉपर्टी सेज, व्हाट इज सेकंड प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ दिस? In parallelogram, this is symbol for parallelogram. Opposite sides are equal. Okay, this property I have used for proving first property. First property में हम by S A S A से भी कर सकते हैं. बराबर. First property हम यूज कर सकते हैं. इंस्टेड ऑफ दिस, सपोज यू वांट टू यूज डेफिनेशन, देन इसमें आप क्या यूज करोगे? आपको पता है, इंस्टेड ऑफ SSS में तो मैंने क्या प्रॉपर्टी यूज की? अगर मुझे प्रॉपर्टी यूज नहीं करना है और डेफिनेशन यूज करना है, तो मैं क्या करूंगी पता है आपको? मैं प्रूव करूंगी, देखो, एंगल 1 इज इक्वल टू एंगल 2, alternate angle. Angle 3 is equal to angle 1 is equal to angle 2, then angle 3 is equal to angle 4, and AC is AC. That way also I can say two triangles are congruent. Okay? Dekho, angle 1 is equal to angle 2 and angle 3 is equal to angle 4. Region kya aayega? Pair of alternate angle. Okay? And AC is equal to CA, right? Common. So triangle ABC is congruent to CDA by SSS की जगह क्या? कौन सा हम यूज कर सकते हैं? ASA. क्या यूज करेंगे हम? By ASA रूल. क्लियर? कौन सा रूल अप्लाइड किया मैंने? बाय बाय ASA रूल. ओके, हियर आई हैव अप्लाइड डेफिनेशन, राइट. पहले जो मैंने प्रूफ दिया था उसमें मैंने प्रॉपर्टी नंबर 2 यूज की थी फॉर प्रूविंग प्रॉपर्टी नंबर 1. आई हैव यूज ओनली डेफिनेशन. इन पैरेललोग्राम ऑपोजिट साइड्स आर इक्वल. That is, in parallelogram, AB is equal to CD and BC is equal to AD. Clear? Third property says, this also I can prove by CPCT. Two triangle congruent by ASA rule. Therefore, by CPCT, AB is equal to CD and BC is equal to AD. I can prove by congruency, okay? Third property is, in parallelogram, the diagonal AC and BD bisect each other at point O. O is a point of intersection where the diagonal intersect each other. At that point they bisect each other. मतलब, if they intersect each other at O, then AO is equal to CO and BO is equal to DO. If I draw like this, suppose this is a parallelogram AB CD and suppose AC and BD intersect each other at O, then AO is equal to CO and BO is equal to DO. That is your property number 3. Now property number 4. What is property number 4? If diagonal of a quadrilateral bisect each other, converse of that. If diagonals of quadrilateral bisect each other, then it is a parallelogram. So parallelogram is a special case of quadrilateral. जो quadrilateral में diagonal bisect each other करते हैं वो parallelogram होता है. Right? सब quadrilateral parallelogram नहीं होते. A quadrilateral satisfying these any one properties of parallelogram will be a parallelogram. Okay? This is a fourth property. Clear? Converse of property number 3. Now fifth property. Fifth property says, if in a quadrilateral each pair of opposite angles are equal, then it is a parallelogram. And in a parallelogram opposite angles are equal, vice versa. If in a quadrilateral opposite angles are equal, that is, if angle A is equal to angle C and angle B is equal to angle D, then ABCD, quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. And its converse is, in a parallelogram, opposite angles are equal. Vice versa. Okay? So I can say from this, now sixth property is, sixth property says, a quadrilateral is a parallelogram if a pair of opposite sides is equal and parallel. Only one pair of opposite sides are equal and parallel. Then also it is a parallelogram. We need not to check for both sides. A quadrilateral is a parallelogram if one pair of opposite sides are equal and parallel. Matlab, if AB is equal to CD and AB is parallel to CD, then also ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay? So from this all property we can say one fact, ke bhai, every parallelogram is a quadrilateral. Okay? Every parallelogram is a quadrilateral. Because parallelogram is a closed figure formed by more than three sides. Matlab four sides. Exactly four sides. Every parallelogram is a quadrilateral, but every quadrilateral is not a parallelogram, okay? Every quadrilateral is not a parallelogram. Because parallelogram banne ke liye special property quadrilateral has to satisfy. Barabar? Parallelogram to satisfy the definition of quadrilateral. So, all the parallelogram is a quadrilateral, but all the quadrilateral is not a parallelogram. Now we are talking about rectangle. How I define rectangle? रेक्टेंगल आई डिफाइन इन टर्म्स ऑफ पैरेललोग्राम. रेक्टेंगल होने के लिए पैरेललोग्राम होना जरूरी है. ओके और पैरेललोग्राम पहले क्वाड्रिलेटरल को क्या बनना पड़ेगा? पैरेललोग्राम. अब पैरेललोग्राम इज अ रेक्टेंगल इफ वन ऑफ इट्स एंगल, वन ऑफ इट्स एंगल इज राइट एंगल. व्हाई वन ऑफ द एंगल इज राइट एंगल? बिकॉज वन एंगल राइट एंगल होगा तो बाकी के तीन एंगल भी राइट एंगल बन जाएंगे, बिकॉज ऑपोजिट से एंगल्स आर इक्वल. सपोज एंगल ए इज 90, सो एंगल सी इज गोइंग टू बिकम 90, बिकॉज ए इज इक्वल टू सी इन पैरेललोग्राम एंड बी इज इक्वल टू डी एंड टोटल सम इज 360. दो का सम 180 है तो दूसरे दो का सम भी 180 एंड ईच वन इज इक्वल टू 90 बिकॉज बोथ आर इक्वल. इन फिगर देखो ए बी सी डी जा मैं बनाती हूं. सो ए बी सी डी इन फिगर ए बी सी डी जा रेक्टेंगल. व्हाई इट इज अ रेक्टेंगल? यू सी दिस एंगल इज इट शुड बी 90. ए इज 90 सो सी इज ऑल्सो 90 बिकॉज ए एंड सी आर इक्वल and B and D are also equal, so B and D are also going to become a 90 degree. Now, so rectangle satisfied, rectangle is a parallelogram, right? All rectangle are parallelogram, but all parallelogram are not rectangle. Rectangle is a parallelogram, therefore it satisfied all the properties of parallelogram. Okay, parallelogram. Besides the properties of parallelogram, also some extra properties are satisfied by rectangle. Also, the diagonals are of equal length. Diagonals are of equal length, extra property of rectangle, that is AC is equal to BD. If ABCD is a rectangle, then it satisfied all the properties of parallelogram plus one additional property, that diagonal are always of equal length. Matlab in rectangle diagonals are always of equal length. Now we are talking about rhombus. What is rhombus? It is a parallelogram. It is also a parallelogram whose all sides are equal. So it also satisfied all the properties of parallelogram. Clear? It is a parallelogram whose all sides are equal. That is AB is equal to BC is equal to CD is equal to DA. Adjacent side are equal. Okay. It is also a parallelogram. It is a parallelogram. Therefore, it satisfy all the properties of parallelogram. Beside that, it satisfied one more property. What is another property? Also, here diagonal AC is perpendicular to diagonal BD. This is an additional property of rhombus. Okay. If I draw a rhombus, see this is rhombus. A, B, C, D. If I join this diagonal, they bisect each other, but they bisect each other at right angle. Kya? They bisect each other at O, but at right angle. Matlab here, angle AOB is equal to angle BOC is equal to angle COD is equal to angle DOA. All these angles are of 90 degree. Rectangle में diagonal are of equal length and per rhombus में diagonal are of here all four sides are equal. Clear? And they are all sides are equal and therefore the diagonal are bisect each other at right angle. Now we are talking about square. Everything you have learned in your standard 8. It's a revision. Square. Now I can define square in terms of a rectangle. Okay? It is a rectangle. So, here all properties of parallelogram as well as all properties of rectangle, diagonal are of equal length. And not only that, it is a rectangle whose all, with all sides equal. With all sides equal. So it is rhombus also. With all sides equal. So it is a parallelogram with all sides equal and it is a rectangle. So at least one angle is 90 degree. So it is a perfect regular quadrilateral. So here almost all properties are satisfied by a square. Here diagonal are equal in length and diagonal are also perpendicular. Okay. So it is a rectangle with all sides equal or it is a parallelogram mein define karna hai to it is a parallelogram with all sides equal and one of the angle must be right angle. One angle must be right angle. So square is a rhombus also and square is a rectangle also. So besides the property of parallelogram, it satisfied the properties of parallelogram plus rectangle and rhombus together. So in a square, diagonal are equal and diagonal are perpendicular also. Okay? And all sides equal also. So square hum kaise banayenge? Bolo. Square kaise banayenge hum? Idhar banayenge square? This is my square. Here you will see diagonal bisect each other at right angle. Not only that, here A, B, C, D. All four sides are equal. Not only that, diagonal bisect each other at right angle. And diagonals are bisecting also. Clear? At right angle and they are equal in length also. Okay? So square is a rectangle with all sides equal or it is a parallelogram with all sides equal and at least one of the angle must be right angle. This angle is also right angle. Clear? Now we are talking about trapezium. What is trapezium? In a parallelogram, only one, in a quadrilateral, only one pair of opposite sides are parallel. Not both pair. If one pair of opposite sides of a quadrilateral are parallel, then it is called trapezium. In figure, ABCD is a trapezium. देखो मैं ट्रेपेजियम बनाती हूँ। ओके, ए, बी, सी, डी। हियर ओनली ए बी इज पैरेलल टू सी डी। बी सी इज नॉट पैरेलल टू सी डी। बट इफ ए बी इज पैरेलल टू सी डी एंड ए डी इज इक्वल टू बी सी then it is an isosceles trapezium. Non-parallel sides are equal in length, then it is called isosceles trapezium. Okay, so I can say a parallelogram is a trapezium, but trapezium is not a parallelogram. Kya bol sakte hain hum? A parallelogram because my both pair of opposite sides are parallel, so parallelogram is a trapezium, but trapezium is not a parallelogram. So I can say square, rectangle, rhombus, all are parallelogram, but parallelogram is neither a square, not a rhombus, not a rectangle, not a rhombus, not a square, but parallelogram is a trapezium. Parallelogram is neither square nor rectangle nor a rhombus, but parallelogram is a trapezium. But trapezium is not a parallelogram. Trapezium is only a quadrilateral. Okay. Now last concept is left and that is called kite. Kite to aapne dekha hai. In a quadrilateral, if two pairs of adjacent sides, two pair of opposite nahi, two pair of adjacent sides are equal, it is called kite. Kite is not a parallelogram. Right, kite is not a parallelogram, but rectangle square and rhombus and trapezium are all parallelogram. Rectangle, square, rhombus, and trapezium. Kite is not a parallelogram. Baki ke sab rectangle, square, rhombus and trapezium are parallelogram. Okay. Only kite is not a parallelogram. Samajh mein aaya? In figure, figure dekho idhar. Idhar hum ye do adjacent side equal karenge aur dusri do adjacent side bhi equal banayenge. Okay. So it is A, B, C and D. Here AB is equal to BC and AD is equal to CD. Okay, A do side equal or A do side equal, then it is a side. Clear? Similarly, rectangle and rhombus are not square, right? सिमिलरली जैसे मैंने बोला कि रेक्टेंगल स्क्वायर रोम्बस एंड ट्रेपेजियम हमारे पैरेललोग्राम, बट रेक्टेंगल एंड रोम्बस आर नॉट स्क्वायर, बट स्क्वायर इज अ रेक्टेंगल एंड रोम्बस. ओके, रेक्टेंगल एंड रोम्बस आर नॉट स्क्वायर, तो आप कंपेरिजन से डिसाइड कर सकते हैं. बट स्क्वायर कैन बी कॉल्ड एज अ स्क्वायर इज रेक्टेंगल एंड रोम्बस बोथ एज वेल एज रोम्बस. स्क्वायर कैन बी अ रेक्टेंगल एंड रोम्बस, बट रोम्बस एंड स्क्वायर कैन नॉट बी अ रेक्टेंगल. क्लियर? So, I have given the comparative idea, okay, of all different types of parallelogram. Now, we are doing a new concept and that is the midpoint theorem. Proof is not in your syllabus. Proof you are going to learn in your standard 10th. What is midpoint theorem? The line segment joining the midpoints of two sides of a triangle. Is parallel to the third side. And is half the third side. Its length is half the length of third side. Now see, figure it like this. You have drawn a triangle ABC, okay? ABC. D is a midpoint of AB and E is a midpoint of AC. Then this D line segment joining D and E is parallel to BC and D is half of BC. Here in triangle ABC, D and E are the midpoints of AB and AC respectively. Right? Then midpoint theorem says D is parallel to BC. Not only that, DE, length of DE is one half of BC. Clear? This is your midpoint theorem. Now the converse of midpoint theorem. You should remember this and you should apply it for solving some. Converse of midpoint theorem. Proof is not in your course. Only you have to remember this statement. What is the converse of midpoint theorem? Converse of midpoint theorem is the line drawn through the midpoint of one side of triangle. Midpoint of one side of triangle. And parallel to second side, parallel to another side. Bisect the third side. Matlab, if in triangle ABC, if D is the midpoint of AB and DE is drawn parallel to BC, then DE bisect BC. That is, AE is equal to C. That what it says. Suppose I draw a figure. D is the midpoint, and if I draw D parallel to BC, then D bisect AC, matlab AC is equal, A is equal to C. That what we want to prove. Clear? So this different type of quadrilateral and two theorem, midpoint theorem and converse of midpoint theorem. I am giving you one example based on midpoint theorem. See here, L, M, and N are three parallel lines intersected by transversals. P and Q such that L, M, and N cut off equal intercepts. AB and BC of P. AB and BC of transversal P. Prove that L, M, and N cut off equal intercept D and EF. On Q also. This is what we want to prove. Let us draw the figure. First I draw line L. Okay. Then I draw line M. Okay. Then I draw line N. Okay. Now I draw two transversal P. This is my P. And another is Q. Clear? This is my A, this is my B, this is my C. This is my D, this is my E, this is my F. If I join A and F, let intersect this line M at G. Okay, dikh raha hai na? You are given AB is equal to BC and you are asked to prove D is equal to EF. This is D and this is EF. Okay, so how to prove? Dekho, hum kya karenge? Join AF, let it intersect line M at G. Join AF, let it intersect line M at G. Now first I will take triangle ACF. In triangle ACF and इन ट्राइंगल ACF हम लेंगे एंड उसमें क्या दिया है ACF में सीधी फिगर इन ट्राइंगल ACF क्या दिया है AB इज इक्वल टू AC दिया है बराबर है AB इज इक्वल टू सॉरी BC दिया है देयरफॉर B इज द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ AC क्लियर B इज द मिड पॉइंट ऑफ AC एंड यू आर गिवन B इज पैरेलल टू CF because M is parallel to N that is BG is also parallel to CF because G lies between B and F clear BG is parallel to CF therefore by the converse of midpoint theorem converse of the midpoint theorem what I can say BG bisect AF BG bisects AF clear so what I can get AG is equal to GF therefore AG is equal to GF आ गया Now I am taking, now in triangle, कौन सा triangle लूंगी मैं AG is equal to GF. Therefore, it implies G is the midpoint of what? AF. Clear? Now in triangle, FAD, देखो, FAD में triangle लो. क्या midpoint दिया है? G is the midpoint of FA and G is parallel to AD. क्यों भाई? Because M is parallel to L. Clear? So, by the converse of midpoint theorem, देखो, this is a very good application of the converse of midpoint theorem. Converse of midpoint theorem, I can say G bisects what FD. Therefore, FE is equal to ED. That implies D is equal to EF. वो तो मुझे प्रूव करना है. हो गया I applied converse of midpoint theorem how many times? Twice. Now 8.1 based on properties of different types of quadrilateral and 8.2 based on what? Midpoint theorem and its converse. So next lecture we are going to start sums from an exercise 8.1 clear